series offered by the Fathomalla Homeopathic Medical College, Mangalore. It is a platform provided for homeopathic practitioners and students all over India to enhance their knowledge by listening to the stalwarts of homeopathy. It's my privilege to welcome our administrator, Reverend Father Roshan Krascha, Principal Dr. Shivaprasad K, Vice Principal Dr. ESJ Prabhugiran for this session today. I also welcome the speaker for today's session, Dr. Gobu Shankar M, who is here to speak on the topic Staphylococcus Unraveled. I welcome the moderator for today's session, Dr. Rajachandra G, Associate Professor, Department of Medicine. I request the moderator to take over the session. Over to you, sir.
So good evening, all of you. And from my side, also a warm welcome to everybody present here. Thank you, Dr. Hafiz, for introducing me. I thought suddenly moderator changed. Okay. Okay. So I take the privilege to introduce a person whom I know personally because I met him in 2017 for a conference here at Fathomalla, for a pediatric conference. And the topic is also looks to be very dear because it's from Materia Medica. So first and foremost, I would like to introduce Dr. Gopu Shankar. With a few interaction with Dr. Gopu Shankar, actually it was a little difficult for us to get his bio data because sir always gives a very small bio data. Dr. Dheeraj had tough time to deliver that bio data from sir. Today afternoon, as I was talking to Dr. Gopu Shankar, we got some information. I would like to share this information with you. When we speak to Dr. Gopu Shankar, he is already an influencer, but he also got influenced by two important gurus in his life. One is the direction of his practice and also the influence into homeopathy by Dr. Praful Vijayaka. And another one is his favorite guru. Through him, he learned the art of life, and also I think his bike riding abilities got from Ms. Jaggi was there, sir. Okay, so these two information we got in the afternoon. Anyway, I would like to introduce him. Sir has finished his BHMS from very famous ANSS Homeopathy Medical College from Kottayam. He has passed out in the year 2005 from the university with a first rank holder. He was a first rank holder. And in 2005, he came into contact with Dr. Praful Vijayakar in a seminar organized by IHMA in the city of Calicut. And in 2009, sir completed his MD from the prestigious Organon of Medicine subject and also from the prestigious Government Homeopathic Medical College, Trivandrum. In 2010, sir decorated a job in CCRH Kottayam as a senior research fellow. But due to his acquaintance with Dr. Praful Vijayakar and also predictive homeopathy, he quit the job and joined with Dr. Praful Vijayakar's team, and he became a partner and a senior consultant in Predictive Homeopathic Center, Kochi. And as generally we say that we cannot choose our parents, we cannot choose our siblings, but we can choose only our wife. So actually, sir's father being a professor in psychiatry in Alappi Medical College, brother is also a doctor, he's a maxillofacial surgeon from Amrita Medical College, but his wife is a homeopath, that's what I say. He has chosen a homeopath as his partner. It was nice to hear from sir. His favorite is he loved to read books, he loved to listen to music, and as I already told, he was influenced by Guruji Jaggi Vasudev, and he's a good bike rider. Sir enjoys riding bike, and he also says that he has a Triumph Bonvillie bike with him. So sir, with these few words, I introduce you to the gathering, and sir is going to speak today on a topic called Staphylococcus Unraveled. Staphylococcus Unraveled. Materia Medica itself is a mine, gold mine. And there are few teachers who can actually work like a miner who can bring the gold back to us. It is my privilege. I heard about the drug called Sepia from Dr. Praful Vijayakar in Agra. So I understood that for a Materia Medica teacher, he doesn't need a textbook, he doesn't need anything. Sir just opened Wikipedia, and through Wikipedia, he just showed us Sepia. It was so clear for us. And also I had a privilege of many great Materia Medica teachers. Today we have Dr. Gopu Shankar, and he's taking this responsibility of teaching a Staphylococcus, both through a drug and also through clinical practice. So sir, with expectant hearts and with a privileged hearts, we wait to listen to you. Sir, the floor is open to you. Kindly start the session. Sir, please unmute, sir. Please unmute you.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir. You are audible. You are audible.
Thank you, Dr. Rajachandran.
Yes, sir.
Good evening, friends. Namaskaram to Dr. Shiva Prasad, sir. Everyone here. So I can start the session now. Okay, so we are starting the session. So welcome to Stuffy's Agri Unraveled. So before I start, I would like to pay my tribute to our master Hanuman. And next, my teacher, my inspiration and motivation to continue learning process in this beautiful science of homeopathy, Dr. Prafulji Vijayakar, who is my mentor in homeopathy. So this is the beautiful Stuffy's Agria flower. The Stuffy's Agria medicine is prepared by Master Hanuman himself. He introduced Stuffy's Agria into our literature, and the tincture is prepared from the seeds of Stuffy's Agria. So before we start, for those who are uninitiated into the principles of predictive homeopathy, I would like to share some insight into the basic defense mechanism before starting our session. So Hanuman taught us that there are three miasms: sora, psychosis, and syphilis. So in predictive homeopathy, we have sora, psychosis, and syphilis as three defenses. So in order to understand defense, you have to understand the basic function of a cell. So cell has three basic functions. The first basic function of a cell is to survive by means of oxygen and nutrition. When the survival part of the cell is taken care of, the next function comes, that is a reproduction. So the second function of a cell is a reproduction and generation. The third basic function of a cell is survival of the self, or immunity, protection of the self and protection of the species. So whenever a cell is injured or threatened by an injurious agent, it tries to protect itself by sacrificing the first function of nutrition and respiration. This is the primary defense of a cell, that is physiological defense response. Here, no structure is compromised. Only the physiology comes into play, and this is what we call as soric defense. When the soric defense is not able to counteract the injurious stimuli, the cell makes use of the secondary defense of a reproduction, and it goes into psychotic defense. Psychotic defense are of two types. It can be psychosis excess, where there is hypertrophy or hyperplasia, and second one is psychosis less, where there is a less of production of tissues, that is hypoplasia or hypertrophy. Or we can say that when the soric defense fails, the cell enters into the secondary psychotic defense. And if the cell fails to defend itself by first and secondary defense, it goes automatically into what is called tertiary defense. And tertiary defense is by destruction, by two means. First, the organism tries to protect the whole by sacrificing a part of the organism, and this is known as necrosis. Or if it fails to protect the whole by sacrificing a part, it can go into apoptosis or self-destruction, that is what is called autoimmune defense. So there are three defenses. Soric defense means physiological defense by means of inflammation. Psychotic defense means constructive defense by using the function of reproduction, and tertiary defense is destruction or syphilitic defense response. So coming back to Staphylococcus aureus, we can see that Staphylococcus aureus acts predominantly on nerves and intellect. The second sphere of action is on teeth. And third is on genitourinary organs. And next is on fibrous tissues, eyelids, and skin. So the chief action of Staphylococcus aureus is on nerves and intellect. So it is basically a nerve remedy. So what are the triggering points for a Staphylococcus aureus pathology? So the main triggering points which can result in a pathological response is mortification, humiliation, and chagrin. What do you mean by mortification? Mortification means a deep sense of shame or embarrassment. Another triggering point for Staphylococcus aureus is indignation. What do you mean by indignation? It is righteous anger. When you are accused of an offense which is not done by you, it is righteous anger. The next point is wounded honor, insults, and offenses. Then shame is another important triggering point for Staphylococcus aureus. Disappointed love and grief, and suppressed anger. So these are the main mental triggering points for a Staphylococcus aureus pathology. Next, abuse in any form can cause a Staphylococcus aureus pathology, especially sexual abuse. So Staphylococcus aureus, along with arnica and aconite, is one of the main medicine for trauma, mental and physical, after rape. So lot of sexual excesses can lead to a Staphylococcus aureus pathology. Then people or children who are prone to excessive masturbation again lead to Staphylococcus aureus symptomatology. And on the physical side, any suppression of condylomata and warts can lead to Staphylococcus aureus pathology. So these are the three main themes of Staphylococcus aureus. One is dignity, second one is anger, and third one is sexuality. So when you think of Staphylococcus aureus, three themes must come into your mind. One is dignity, two is anger, and third is sexuality. So what is the disposition of Staphylococcus aureus? So Hahnemann has always taught us that disposition is the most important point in the final selection of a remedy. If you cover the symptomatology of a patient with a remedy, but if the remedy does not match the disposition of the patient, then it is not able to cure conformably according to natural laws. So what do you mean by disposition? Disposition means a more or less constant reaction to a series of stimulus in the environment, which is either internal or external, and that which is genetically programmed. So disposition comes from the genes. So what type of disposition is Staphylococcus aureus? So Staphylococcus aureus is suited to persons who are very timid, sheepish, morbidly sensitive, mentally and physically. Mind you, the word morbidly sensitive. Staphylococcus aureus people are very much morbidly sensitive to even to imaginable insults. They are people with a guilty and abashed look. They are very impressionable and susceptible people. Impressionable means they take in every inputs from the environment. They are very susceptible. They are very nervous and irritable patients who are always in a state of worry. They are always in a state of melancholy. They are always sad and depressed and irritable people. They are very much gloomy and introverted, like natrums and sepia. And in the initial stage, Staphylococcus aureus is always affectionate, but when the miasm, as I said, in Sora, the Staphylococcus aureus people are very much affectionate, but when the miasm changes to psychosis, they become amorous. Means, become amorous means what? They have love inclined to sexuality, people inclined to sexual love, that not platonic. So in Sora they have platonic love, and in psychosis they are disposed to amorous love, sexual love. So these people are basically very diligent and conscientious people. They are very hardworking. They are very knowledge accumulating persons, very scrupulous. They are very gentle. They are very truthful. They have a good boy or good girl image in schools and colleges. They are very ambitious people, but this ambition has again a peculiarity. Staphysagria people are ambitious for fame. But whereas Arsenicum, Naxomica, Aurum, they are ambitious for money also. But Staphysagria is ambitious only for fame. And they are basically anxious people, and they have anxiety for others also. And they are basically affectionate people, and they are very homesick also. So this is the basic disposition of Staphysagria. Very timid, sensitive, physically and mentally sensitive, guilty look, gloomy, introverted, affectionate people, but they have a tendency to go into sexual love. They are very diligent, conscientious, ambitious people, but the ambition is for fame or position, not for money. They are not into money making. They are ambitious for fame, and they are very homesick people. So the main theme of Staphysagria is dignity and honor. So Staphysagria are very gentle people, and they will not sacrifice their dignity and honor. They will not sacrifice their dignity and honor. And let us see some of the rubrics in repertory which indicates the dignity and honor, the perception of Staphysagria. What is the perception of Staphysagria in the repertory? You can see that Staphysagria has a delusion of humility and lowness of others while he is great, where Staphysagria is one among the three medicines along with germanium and platinum. He has a delusion that he is great and others are low. Another delusion of Staphysagria is that he is too large, delusion that he is much taller and surrounding objects are much lower, delusion that he is taller, and delusion he is insulted. So you can see that Staphysagria is very much morbidly sensitive to insults. So sometimes these insults are imaginable. Actually, the situation is not insulting, but Staphysagria takes the situation as insulting to his honor. That is why Kent has said that Staphysagria suffers from imaginable insults, not only from real situations of insult. Staphysagria suffers from imaginable situations, imaginable insults. Next, I have told that Staphysagria people are extremely sensitive. This sensitivity can be seen at the mental, emotional, and physical side. At the mental side, you can see that they are too touchy people, but they will not express their sensitiveness. And at the physical side, you can see in the Materia Medica that the ulcers are sensitive, the teeth are sensitive, any lesion that coming on the body is sensitive, so that even a touch on the ulcer or even a touch on the injurious part will throw the person into convulsions or spasms. That much is the sensitiveness of Staphysagria. So much of exaggerated sensitivity. This is sorosyphilis, exaggeration, sorosyphilis. So Staphysagria is extremely sensitive, both emotionally and physically. So where all this sensitivity is found? So you can see that sensitivity of Staphysagria is towards all the external impressions, all the moral impressions, especially to rudeness, to rough behavior of others, to loss of position, to friendly reprimands like admonition, reproaches, reprimands, criticism, and especially to what other people say about her. So Staphysagria persons are generally very much image conscious because of their dignity, because of their self-esteem. So they will try to keep the image high. So they are always obsessed about what other people say about her or him. So other people's opinions matters to Safi Sagitya. So they will try to save their image in front of the public by any means. They will not show up their anger initially. They will not speak rudely to anyone in the public initially. They will maintain a gentleman image in society, because if they speak up or if they behave rudely, their dignity is lost. They do not want to sacrifice their dignity at any cost. But mind you, so Safi Sagitya is extremely sensitive in initial stages of SORA. There is sensitivity in psychosis, but in syphilis, the entire sensitivity is lost. So in syphilis, as I already told, it is the destructive defense response. So in syphilis, there is destruction of sensitivity in syphilis. So the sensitivity is totally lost in Safi Sagitya at the mental and physical level, so much so that Safi Sagitya can have suicidal disposition. His sensitivity to life will be lost at the end stage. So what is the anger of Safi Sagitya? So Safi Sagitya is a person who is disposed to get angry and irritable easily. But the importance, the peculiarity of Safi Sagitya is that it has a tendency to swallow anger. It will repress or suppress its anger. And there is a peculiarity of Safi Sagitya anger. Because Safi Sagitya suppresses his anger, his face becomes pale. This is in contradiction to other remedies like belladonna and sulfur, where the face becomes red. There is actual congestion in belladonna with anger, while sulfur has a pseudo congestion. Sulfur's face is always red. And Safi Sagitya, when angry, the face becomes pale. And he can get anger over his own mistakes and others. And initially he will swallow his anger, he will suppress his anger, but after a period of time, there will be occasional outburst of anger, which results in throwing things or shouting, or he can become violent. And Kent has written beautifully that a gentleman in his office has a fight with his subordinate, and he subdues his wrath, subdues his pent-up wrath, and goes home sick and trembling with anger. So as a result of anger, Safi Sagitya trembles and loses his ability to express himself. He loses his voice. He becomes weak, and he can get sick in head and intestines. So Farrington has beautifully narrated the colic of Safi Sagitya. He has written that Safi Sagitya has a mental colic. Mental colic resulting from mental causes. So Safi Sagitya has a mental colic similar to chamomile and colocin. These are the other two remedies which is famous for mental colic. We will come to that later. So finally, Safi Sagitya is prone to violent anger, like exploding of a pressure cooker. After so much repression, suppression, and swallowing of anger, Safi Sagitya can explode violently, leading to rage and destruction. So this pent-up wrath in the long term can cause insanity when the syphilitic defense predominates. So this long continued suppressed anger in the long run, in the long term, can cause even intellectual deterioration and insanity in syphilitic phase of Safi Sagitya. This is the last phase. So what are the sudden effects of anger in a Safi Sagitya constitution? So this sudden effects of anger again depends on the miasm. If the effect is SORA, then there will be headache, colic, diarrhea. And when it changes miasm to syphilis, it leads to vomiting, hoarseness, then breathing difficulty, palpitation, convulsions, and even to paralysis and syncope or fainting. So these are the sudden effects of anger in a Safi Sagitya constitution: headache, colic, diarrhea, vomiting, hoarseness, breathing difficulty, palpitation, convulsions, paralysis, and fainting. So the third important theme of Staphysagria is sexuality. So there is lot of sexual repression in Staphysagria. The needs of sexuality is not met in a Staphysagria person. Also, the Staphysagria personality resort to sexuality as a means to vent up his mental and emotional insults and sufferings. So Staphysagria is a person who resorts to sexuality as a vent to his emotional sufferings. So as the saying goes, as long as sex is confined to your body, it is biology, it is fine. But if the sex is into your mind, then it becomes a disease. And as long as it is confined to your body, it is biology and it is fine. But if it enters into your mind, then it becomes a disease and perversion. So Staphysagria is a person with excessive sexual desire, resorting to masturbation and excessive coition. So it is one of the few medicines in our repertory or materia medica for ailments from sexual excesses in children, where it shares the same platform with platina, origanum, and hyoscyamus. And similar to platina, Staphysagria has extreme sensitivity of the external genitalia. It is written in platina that a touch of the napkin can cause the woman to convulsions in platina. The same situation is there in Staphysagria also. Extreme sensitiveness, so that even the touch of napkin is unbearable. So Staphysagria person is a person who constantly dwells on sexual subjects, who is a person addicted to sexual literature and pornography, has lot of sexual dreams, night pollutions, etc. And he is a person who always thinks of lavish sexual intercourse. And he has a tendency to brood on past disagreeable occurrences, especially sexual. So Staphysagria is the only medicine in repertory for dwelling on past disagreeable occurrences, which is sexual. And later he develops tormenting sexual thoughts, which can lead to obsessive compulsive disorder. And when the miasm of syphilis predominates, Staphysagria develops an extreme aversion to opposite sex, which results in homosexuality and all sorts of sexual perversions. And at this stage, Staphysagria develops a lot of obsessive thoughts, and he will, after that, he will react to that obsessions, and he will compulsively react to the thoughts in his mind, and again, a frank OCD will develop. And after a lot of intelligence in sex and sexual matters, finally, the intellect of Staphysagria is deteriorated, which results in confusion and dullness. So again, there is a peculiarity of confusion in Staphysagria. The confusion is periodical. It is not always present. It is exactly periodical in nature. And Staphysagria is one of the medicine in our materia medica who can develop insanity from excessive sex. And he has a tendency for atrophy and shriveling of sexual organs after too much intelligence. And finally, he will go into impotency. So what is the basic carrot? I have already told that Staphysagria. So we have looked into the basic themes of Staphysagria. The basic three themes are there. One is dignity. He will do whatever possible to maintain his dignity, even he has a fear of losing his reason, or he has a fear of catching insanity by suppressing his anger. He is suppressing his anger to protect this dignity. If he speak up or if he speak rudely, his dignity will be lost. He has to maintain his dignity. That is why in the initial stages, Taphisagra is swallowing his anger. He is too dignified to fight back. So he will protect this dignity at any cost. Then the second theme is anger. We have looked into that. So there is a lot of repressed or suppressed anger in Taphisagra, which can lead to occasional outburst like a pressure cooker. And in syphilis, it leads to violence and rage. And in syphilis, the physical effects of anger are in syphilitic phase, especially in syphilitic phase, Taphisagra can go into convulsions, paralysis, and syncope. And in the psoriatic effects of anger are headache, colic, and diarrhea. So he can also develop palpitation after too much violent anger. So we have seen that Taphisagra is basically a very hardworking person, very diligent, very honest person, very conscientious, scrupulous person, and he is ambitious. And he is ambitious only for fame. When you see the other ambitious remedies in our Materia Medica, you can find that arsenicum is both for fame and money. Naxomega is both for fame, money, and position. So Taphisagra is much interested only for fame or position, not for money. He is not into money-making business. So Taphisagra, you can see that in the rubric ailments from financial laws, there is no Taphisagra. See that. Only 13 remedies in the repertory for ailments from financial laws. You can see arnica is there because arnica is money is so much important to arnica. Arsenicum is money oriented. Aurum is money oriented. Calcarea is money oriented. Ignatia, Mesirium, Natrum, Naxomica, again fame and money. Pulsatilla, money for support. Rexto, Sarsaparilla, Stanum, Veratrum. These are all money oriented, and these people are affected by loss of money. So people who are sensitive to something becomes affected by the loss of that something. So people who are sensitive to money will be affected by the loss of finance. So Taphisagra is not listed in the ailments from financial laws also. So it is a remedy which is sensitive to fame only or position. So Taphisagra is affected by loss of position only, not by financial loss. So what are the fears of Taphisagra? So the first and most important fear of Taphisagra is fear of losing self-control. Why? Because Taphisagra is using so much control not to react. He cannot react to protect his dignity. So finally, he has a fear of losing his self-control. And he has a fear of losing reason or fear of insanity also. And you can see that people who are ambitious for position, people who are ambitious for fame, has a tendency to be afraid of high places. Taphisagra has a tendency to be afraid of high places also. And initially, you have seen that Taphisagra is basically an affectionate person in Sora. In psychosis, Taphisagra is having amorous disposition, that means sexual love. And in syphilis, Taphisagra's sexuality turns to homosexuality. So before turning to homosexuality, somewhere in the psychosis phase, Taphisagra starts fearing of his own homosexuality nature. Just before the syphilitic phase, Taphisagra starts fearing of his own nature, his own sexual orientation. And he has a fear to lose his lucrative position because he is ambitious of his position. He is ambitious of fame. So naturally, in psychosis, he has a fear to lose his position. And also, Taphisagra has a tendency to fear about his social position. Again, same reason, he is insecure about his position. He is always worried about his position and image in the society. He is very image conscious. And he has a poverty fear similar to bryonia. He has a fear of poverty, which has similar intensity to that of bryonia, and a fear to bring up his family in psychosis. So in the syphilitic stage, So in psychosis, Tafisagri has a lot of fears, fear of self-control, fear of insanity, fear of high places, fear of losing position. But when the syphilitic miasm predominates, when it goes into syphilitic stage, you can see the intellect is affected. So in the intellect, Staphysagria causes a confusion. And this confusion results after long continued years of over-sexual indulgence. So the peculiarity of Staphysagria confusion is that it is periodical. And this confusion occurs whenever he talks or whenever he attempts to concentrate on something. And this confusion also comes on waking up and also after coition. And also he has confusion during vertigo and during mental exertion. So the most important thing of Staphysagria confusion is that it is periodical and it comes after long continued indulgence in sex. Then it affects the memory in syphilis. He starts forgetting names of persons, of places, dates, forms, colors, and even he cannot identify a person. He completely forgets that person. He forgets what he has read. He forgets what he is about to say. He forgets things that has just happened before. He forgets even the words while speaking. And he hunts for words literally when speaking. So in hearing guiding symptoms, it is written that he will develop want of memory with heavy weight between the eyes. A few minutes after reading anything, the sense escapes him and he is scarcely able to recall it even after long reflection. And he starts making mistakes. He omits words while talking. He uses wrong words. He makes mistakes in writing. He makes mistakes in time. And he makes confusion. He has confusion in future, past, and present. He confounds the future with the past. He confounds the present with the past. These are all syphilis. Confounding time, confounding future and past, present and past. These are all syphilitic shades of Staphysagria. And lastly, he developed vanishing of thoughts. And thoughts vanish when he tries to exert his mind, when he tries to read anything, when he tries to talk or think anything, when he tries to write, and whenever he is interrupted while he is saying something, his thoughts will vanish and his mind will become a blank page. And he has difficulty in concentration, and whenever he tries to concentrate, a vacant feeling comes to his mind. So these are all syphilitic side of Staphysagria. So in the syphilis, in the syphilitic defense, Staphysagria usually or greatly affect the intellect and neurological system. And in Allen's Encyclopedia, one prover has reported, thoughts disappear whenever he attempts to think or speaks of any subject. And if anyone interrupts him or changes to another subject, he for the moment forgets or cannot at all collect his thoughts. And lastly, Staphysagria will enter into prostration of mind, complete mental prostration. We have seen another remedy for such a state, that is picric acid. But picric acid has developed prostration of mind after shock. But Staphysagria has developed prostration of mind after long continued sexual indulgence. So prostration of mind from slightest mental exertion, and prostration of mind leading to convulsions, and prostration of mind from vexation. And physically, you can see that Staphysagria persons are chilly people, thirstless. Basically, they are thirstless, fast people. They are usually left-sided because of the sensitivity, but they can be also right-sided people, and they have a tendency for crossways affection. So crossways affection is also syphilis, where the left upper part of the body is affected with the right lower part. So this is syphilitic symptom, left upper affection and right lower affection, crossways affection. So they are basically chilly, thirstless, fast people, usually left-sided, but they can also be right-sided with crossways affection prone to left upper and right lower.
It appears there is a connection problem. Kindly bear with us.
Hello?
Yes, sir. We can see the slides.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Next, we can look into the main features of a Staphysagria child. So Staphysagria child as an infant is an infant with delayed dentition, who is pot-bellied, whose nutrition is sacrificed. He a very irritable child. So whenever you see a Staphysagria child, you will mistake it for Camomilla. So similar to Camomilla, these children are very much irritable, very much fretful, very much angry child. And you can see that you have mistakenly given Camomilla for many Staphysagria infants and toddlers, because so much anger and irritability is found also in the Staphysagria child. But the basic difference between Camomilla and Staphysagria is that Staphysagria are chilly and Camomilla is hot. And also another differentiating point is Camomilla children are having hot perspiration with a hot face and red cheeks. So this is one important point which differentiates a Camomilla baby from a Staphysagria child. And you can see that a Staphysagria infant or children are very sensitive and irritable, very cross and peevish like that of a Camomilla child. And these children has a tendency to sleep all day and awake all night. And another important peculiarity of Staphysagria children is that they are confused and dull on waking up, and they are very much capricious like Camomilla and Cinna. They push everything away and wants everybody to go away. They have excessive hunger. Even with a full stomach, they are extremely hungry. They have insatiable hunger. They are pot-bellied children who are prone to frequent colic. And Staphysagria is a very important remedy for colic resulting from worms in children, similar to Cinna, Camomilla, and Stanomet. Staphysagria should also be thought of in such physical disposition. And they have a tendency to suffer from dentition. They have delayed teething, and the teeth has a peculiarity. They have black streaks along the teeth, and teeth always decay around the edges. And they have a tendency to rapid decaying of milk teeth. And in children, they are very good boy, good girl, good boy or good girl image. They are having a good boy, good girl image. They are diligent and conscientious. They are very obedient children. But they will misbehave only when their patience is lost. They are obedient to a large extent. They are very obedient people. They are very good boy, good girl type of people, but whenever their patience is lost, they can misbehave. This is one important point. They can misbehave, but when their patience is lost. This is similar to the occasional outburst of anger in Staphysagria adult. And these people will not fight back. They are very timid, sheepish children, and these children will not fight back. They are prone to bullying in school. They are serious and quiet children, and mild with a lot of sensitivity, and they are vulnerable and impressionable children, and they cannot tolerate any consolation. They are aggravated from consolation, similar to Ignatia and Etramur. And these children cannot stand admonition, punishment, and rudeness from others or teachers. They weep from admonition, and they are very bashful and shy people. They are always shy of the opposite sex. See, in Sora, when they are children, they are always shy of the opposite sex. And in syphilis, they develop a strong aversion to opposite sex. See how the symptom changes according to the miasm. In Sora, they are very timid, bashful, and shy of opposite sex. In psychosis, they are indulging in lavish sexual intercourse with the opposite sex. But in syphilis, they develop a strong aversion to opposite sex and develop So they can throw things in anger. So they can develop temper tantrums. They are children who are prone to masturbation. And you can see that as a result of sexual sublimation, these children can develop romantic preoccupation or romantic thoughts, or they can resort to even poetry as a result of their intense sexual urges. As a result of sublimation of this intense sexual desire, the Staphysagria children, especially Staphysagria teens, can milk. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So next we can see the basic miasmatic expression of Staphysagria symptomatology at the mental level. You can see that in Sora, or the primary physiological defense, the basic first defense, these people are very sensitive. They are very sentimental. They have weeping disposition, they are timid, they are affectionate, they are homesick, they are anxious, even anxious for others, they are angry, irritable, capricious, they are people with active concentration, they have a tendency to absorb in things they are involved in, They have total involvement in things. They have an active memory. They are complaining. They are hopeful. So in Sora, you can see the sensitivity, the timid nature, the affectionate nature, the homesickness, the anxiety, the irritability, and a normal intellect in Staphysagria with active concentration and good memory. But when the psychotic miasm comes into play, you can see that Staphysagria becomes absent-minded, Staphysagria starts losing his memory. Staphysagria in the Sora, he is introverted, but in psychosis, he starts being loquacious, he starts being greedy, he starts becoming avaricious, he starts losing his self-confidence, he has a tendency to hide, he becomes a coward, he is scrupulous in Sora, but he becomes heedless or careless in psychosis. His irritability in Sora changes to violent anger in psychosis. His ego becomes bloated. He becomes envious. He becomes haughty, presumptuous, very much ambitious. So much of ego is there so that he becomes intolerant of contradiction. So he also becomes courageous. So you can ask why cowardice and courageous are both in psychosis miasm. So cowardice means less of courage. So this is psychosis, less, and audace, and courageous and audacity means excess. So these are psychotic excess, audacity and courageous nature. And he becomes a flatterer in psychosis, and he has a passion for gambling, abundant ideas, and even make verses. So making verses is a sublimation of the intense sexual needs, or repression of sexuality leads to verses making in Staphysagria people. And you can see that in psychosis, the basic affectionate nature of psychosis is of Staphysagria is transferred or transformed to amorous love. In psychosis, Staphysagria becomes shameless and lascivious. He will be having a lot of lascivious fancies in psychosis. He can become adulterous. So in Sora, he is very honest and diligent, but in psychosis, he becomes adulterous. He has a tendency to jesting and talking bombast, similar to Veratrum. He is so much hurried and impatient and discontented in psychosis. And in syphilis, the same person goes into anguish with anxiety of conscience as if guilty of a crime. He can resort to alcoholism with exaltation of fancies. In psychosis, you can see that he has always fear of losing his social position. But in syphilis, he is despair of social position. And he will start talking irrational things. So that means his intellect is getting deteriorated in syphilis. He starts talking irrational. While in psychosis, his talk was bombast. But in syphilis, his talking becomes irrational. And he starts cursing people. He will be having guilt, remorse. Especially after so much of sexual indulgence, he starts behaving impulsively. He will be having all sorts of morbid impulses leading to rage and even desire to kill somebody who opposes him and wants to set things even on fire or house on fire, and so much of violence in a Staphysagria person. So a gentleman in the soric phase and psychotic phase has converted or transformed into such a violent personality in out of control situation like syphilis. And so much of hatred in syphilis, so much of jealousy, unsympathetic and ungrateful, similar to nitric acid, so much of misanthropy so that he avoids society, he shuns the society, aversion to all the persons, he will not go into the public, he avoids the society, he even cuts off the relation with even family, and leading to total loss of self-control. And always in syphilis, there is suppression of natural inclination. He always desire to suppress his natural inclinations. He will develop libertinism, homosexuality, and all types of sexual perversions, peeping Tom, voyeurism, nymphomania, all in syphilitic stage, when there is total loss of control. And at the intellectual level, these are the main syphilitic effect on Staphylococcus aureus. First is indiscretion. Next is confusion. Then vanishing of thoughts and persisting and tormenting thoughts. She starts making mistakes, starts forgetful, vanishing of senses, prostration of mind, and even up to imbecility. And in the final stage, a very much sensitive person becomes indifferent in syphilis. The total sensitivity is lost totally. He desires death and he starts presentiment of death and with suicidal disposition. So finally, so let us see some of the unique symptoms of Staphylococcus aureus. These are the PQRS symptoms of Staphylococcus aureus. These are also syphilitic symptoms. First one is periodical confusion. This is unique to Staphylococcus aureus. Dullness after mortification. Forgetfulness after pollutions. Fear to bring up his family. Indifference after masturbation. This is very unique to Staphylococcus aureus. Mortification after emissions. Remorse after masturbation. Suppression of natural inclinations. Forced to write with right hand. So unconsciousness or coma or convulsions after being accused unjustly. Vertigo, amelioration from walking in a circle. So strange. Coldness or chilliness in head during stool. Recurrence ties one after the other. Lacerations in injury to cornea. The discharge from nose is first thick and then thin. Contrary to first thin and then thick, Staphylococcus aureus nasal discharge is first thick and then thin. Objects seem large when rising from a seat. And tobacco tastes sour. This is a perverted sensation of Staphylococcus aureus. Tobacco tastes sour. Discoloration of teeth in black streaks. Diarrhea after reprimands. Dysentery after mortification. Cough after indignation. Stunted growth of fingers. Sleeplessness after a dispute. Constriction of throat pit after anger. Hoarseness or weak voice after anger. Loss of voice after anger. A respiratory difficulty towards the end of coition. Atrophy and shriveled testicles after sexual excesses. Seminal discharge is sticky. Hemiplegia after anger. Injuries from sharp instruments. So you can see that in Staphylococcus aureus, he is cut by means of insult. So Staphylococcus aureus at the physical level has ailments from cuts, sharp cutting instruments, injuries from sharp cutting instruments, lacerated and stretched sphincters. So this is Staphylococcus aureus in a nutshell. It's psoric, psychosis, and syphilitic side. Hope you have all understood Staphylococcus aureus in its entirety, from psora to psychosis to syphilis, and its miasmatic representation and the unique symptoms of Staphylococcus aureus. So thank you each and every one of you for a patient hearing.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, there are few questions, sir, from the audience.
Yeah.
Sir, one first question here is, Deepa Amar, who has raised this question, not after money, that Staphylococcus aureus is not after money, but fears poverty. Yeah. Can you please explain this, sir?
Yes. Staphylococcus aureus is not ambitious of making money, but he has always a fear to bring up his family. I have told that Staphylococcus aureus is not into money-making business. As every other human being, he needs money for survival, that much. And he is always afraid of losing his position and thereby bringing up his family. In that way, he is afraid of poverty, not the other way around.
Okay, sir. The second question is crosswise pain in syphilitic. Can you please explain what is the crosswise pain?
Yeah. So in usually in psora, you can see that the pains are in spasms. Pains are tolerable. Pains are bearable. They will come in spasms. They come and go. And they have a regular direction, like above downwards or off the same side. But in syphilis, everything is ulta. So it is erratic. It is wandering. It goes. So there is nothing, there is no scientific explanation why the pain starts from left upper extremity and it goes downwards to the tip of the finger and then it starts on the right hip and going downward. So this is very much strange and peculiar. And you can see that in Aphorism 153, Hahnemann has always told us to give importance to PQRS symptoms in the case. So these PQRS symptoms are always unexplainable, and those that are unexplainable and that are strange are always syphilitic.
Thank you, sir. One more question, sir. How can we differentiate colocynth and Staphylococcus aureus from ailments from indignation? Colocynth and Staphylococcus aureus.
Yeah. So Staphylococcus aureus and colocynth as a relation. Staphylococcus aureus is complementary to colocynth. So both these remedies are very good remedies for ailments from mortification, indignation, and chagrin. So initially, or in lot of cases, colocynth, when we prescribe colocynth is also chilly. Staphylococcus aureus is also chilly. Colocynth can be thirsty or thirstless, but Staphylococcus aureus is basically thirstless. And colocynth is a person who reacts back. He will not suppress or swallow his anger like Staphylococcus aureus. Colocynth is a person who is not dignity oriented. But when a person who swallows his anger due to his to protect his image in society, he swallows his anger and comes back home and suffers from that, then Staphylococcus aureus is indicated. But some cases where colocynth is initially prescribed, where it gives relief to the patient but is not effecting a complete cure, then Staphylococcus aureus will come in and it will complete the cure.
Thank you, sir. One more question, sir, from Dr. Hitesh. He is requesting you, can you please share a couple of cases of Staphy in acute or chronic conditions? Any experiences?
I have not prepared the slides. I can tell you cases, but I have not prepared the slides of that. Maybe in next webinar, we can do that. But in acute case, I can tell you that years back when I was doing my PG, I remembering that case very much. And I was doing my PG in GHMCT and one friend called me and she told me that I am suffering from high grade viral fever. For the past 3 to 4 days, I have taken homeopathic medicines from her. She herself took the medicine and when that fever was not subsided and her general condition becoming worse, she resorted to certain friends. The friends prescribed, her sir prescribed, but nothing helped her. So I told her, what is your thermals? And she told me that she is very chilly. And I asked him, what is your thirst? She is thirstless. And the next thing she told me that she is having extreme hunger. So mind you, this is a golden symptom, extreme hunger with fever. Staphysagria, one dose 200 I have prescribed at, I think it is an afternoon 2 or 3, by 7 o'clock she is perfectly fine. So this is one golden symptom of Staphysagria in acutes. Whenever you find a fever or an acute case with extreme hunger, insatiable hunger, and the person is chilly and thirstless, and especially when it started, and when the symptoms are clear, when you ask the person what triggered the fever, what triggered the fever, you will get an etiology in Staphysagria. It will be a mortification or an indignation or a loss of position, whatever it may be, you will get the etiology right. So this is one acute case, and there are a lot of cases, and there is a beautiful asthma case where I cured. These are all constitutional case taking. No, we are not prescribing on symptom totality alone. We are prescribing on the basis of the miasm, the PQRS, and the innate genetic traits of the person.
Sir, one more, sir. This is a imaginary question. This is not in real. What if both wife and husband are Staphysagria constitutions?
Yes, I will tell you that Staphysagria person is so dignified that he will be ashamed to ask for sex from wife. He is too dignified even to ask for sex from wife even. So when two people are Staphysagria, when husband and wife are Staphysagria, I can't imagine how they get along with. It is very difficult. They will not speak up, no. There will be no transparency. So this will be difficult. So there will be always insults, unimaginable chaos, everything will go on. And a lot of sexual repression and suppression will be also be there.
Yes, sir. One question from Sangeeta, sir. Fear of bringing up family. Can you please compare it with Lycopodium?
What?
Fear of bringing up family. How do we compare it with Lycopodium?
So Lycopodium is coming to Lycopodium. Lycopodium is a diligent person similar to Staphysagria, but Lycopodium, they are very egotic and haughty people. They are very dominating, but with a very much tender heart. They are very much sensitive inside with a hard exterior facade. They are very much sensitive with a hard facade outside. So Lycopodium is having tremendous loss of self-confidence. In order to cover up their self-confidence, they are acting as superior in front of people. So Lycopodium's fear of bringing up his family comes from their lack of self-confidence and inferiority complex.
Absolutely. Yes, sir, that is true. Anticipation is higher.
Yes.
And one more question, sir, from Aishwarya. How to differentiate concern for dignity and honor of aurum and staff?
Yeah, pardon.
Concern for dignity.
Yes.
And honor of aurum and staffing.
Yes. So aurum is a metal and it is gold. Aurum, like Staphysagria, they are very diligent and conscientious people, hardworking people. And their honor is different to Staphysagria. Aurum people are industrious and hardworking. They are born leaders. They know their worth. They are second only to platina.
Okay.
And while Staphysagria is very much sensitive, and they have an error in perception of their honor. They have a tendency to suffer from unimaginable insults. Aurum is not like that. Staphysagria is so much morbidly sensitive that he suffers from unimaginable insults even.
Mm-hmm.
That is the difference.
True,
it is,
sir,
a blotted sense of dignity. It is not actual dignity. Staphysagria is having a blotted sense of dignity.
Dignity
is there, but it is an exaggerated sense of dignity.
Okay. That was nice to understand, sir. Actually, even I never knew that. Because we always worry about why this Staphysagria is so sensitive, until unless we know that it was a bloated sense of dignity.
Yes, it is bloated.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. So we'll take one more question, sir. Here, Sharada, she asked this question, sir. Can you please differentiate fear of poverty of Bryonia and Staphylococcus aureus?
Yes. So Staphylococcus aureus has a fear of poverty and a fear of bringing up his family. So his reaction is, again, Staphylococcus aureus goes into grief and sadness and melancholy. But what Bryonia does is totally different in reaction to the fear of poverty. Bryonia will accumulate food. Bryonia will accumulate money. Bryonia will start working more harder. Bryonia becomes industrious, and Bryonia is positive in that way.
Yes.
Clear? And Bryonia is hot also, thermally hot and right-sided. While Staphylococcus aureus is chilly and left-sided.
Yes, so many questions are coming up, sir. Can I take some more?
Yes.
We have time till 9 o'clock. If you are okay, we will take some more, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Sure. Sir, there is a dwells on past agreeable occurrences. Sexual is due to impotency or disappointed love. Is it due to impotency or disappointed love that he is dwelling on the past sexual occurrences?
Yeah.
Past occurrences, sexual occurrences, he is dwelling on them. Is it because of impotency or disappointed love?
No. So initially, Staphylococcus aureus uses his sexual energy as a vent to the emotional insults and emotional sufferings. And he even commits some sexual sins. When you find the literature of Materia Medica, you can see that Staphylococcus aureus at some point of time suffers from past sexual sins. It is written, past sexual sins. And Staphylococcus aureus develops melancholy and extreme guilt because of that. So that is why. It is guilt.
Yes, sir. Sir, what about, can you so throw some light on suicidal tendency of Staphylococcus aureus by Dilip Chandran?
So there is not any peculiar suicidal methodology for Staphylococcus aureus, but I have told earlier that in the initial stage, Staphylococcus aureus has so much love for life. Staphylococcus aureus is very sensitive, ambitious, and in psychosis, it goes into ego, ambition, hardworking nature. But in syphilis, he becomes indifferent to life, and he starts desiring death. And he then goes into syphilitic autoimmune defense. He decides to end his life. That's all. It is not clear by what method Staphylococcus aureus commits suicide. Repertory, it shows only as suicidal disposition. While in anti-crude or anti-tard, you can see that it has a tendency to commit suicide by drowning.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Arsalb has a tendency to commit suicide by hanging.
Mm-hmm.
Arsenic alb has a tendency to commit suicide by knife. But there is nowhere mentioning Staphylococcus aureus as a particular methodology for suicide.
Yes, thank you. And one more, sir. Actually, left-handed child forcibly converted. Other remedies differentiate, please. Probably this is from a book, A Case Explained.
Other remedies for suppression of natural inclinations. I have to look at the repertory then. I can't, from memory, I have to look into repertory and then answer.
Okay. This is from
one of the other remedies for that. Tuja is one remedy, I think.
Okay.
Tuja is one remedy. Is it clear? Tuja?
Yes, sir. This Dr. George Witalka's Essence of Materia Medica, a small case is explained related to this. Probably this is from that experience she has taken this question.
So I think another remedy for suppression of this natural inclination is Tuja, if my memory is correct.
Okay, sir.
And if I have to differentiate the remedies, then I have to look into the repertory and the rubric, what all other remedies are coming up in this rubric, particular rubric. And I know that Tuja is one among the rubric along with Staphylococcus aureus for converting one left-handed person into right or right-handed person into left. As far as Tuja is concerned, the disposition and the physical constitution is entirely different from Staphylococcus aureus. Well, Staphylococcus aureus is lean, thin, tall, While Tuja is dark, obese, with lot of oil grease on face, lot of warts and condylomata. And again, Tuja has also decayed teeth, but the teeth decaying is on the crowns, while Staphysagrae is on the edges. And Tuja is having digestion problems, lot of indigestion, flatulence. And Tuja is slow, but Staphysagrae as a child is fast, while Tuja is slow, like a dark calcarea. And Tuja, Staphysagrae is very morbidly sensitive, while Tuja is very morbidly insecure. Tuja has a lot of insecurity. Tuja feels Tuja is fragile. So he feels that he has a delusion of that legs are made of wood or legs are made of glass. He's so fragile. So fragility is the keyword for Tuja. And sensitivity, morbidly sensitive is the keyword for Staphysagrae. Hope this will differentiate Tuja and Staphysagrae. I don't know what all other remedies are coming up in suppression of left and right. Maybe carcinosin may come up in this rubric.
Okay, sir. There's a curiosity-oriented question from Harina Sharma. He asks, which two constitutions are good to be husband and wife?
Wife.
Husband and wife. Which two constitutions are best as
I would say for a good marriage. So before answering this question, we have to look into the subject of marriage.
Yes.
So what is marriage? So marriage means it is a social contract. So two persons enter into the institution of marriage as a social contract. So in marriage, always there is adjustment, a compromise. So unless and until one person is able to compromise or adjust to other person's needs and desires, that will not work. So if one person is egotic like Naxomikya, the opposite person must be mild, amicable, and yielding like Pulsatilla. Then only that will work. If two Platinas enter into a marriage contract, it will not go for more than one day. Even after the first night, they will be broken. So the basic constitution of two persons will play a pivotal role in a successful marriage. So marriage means adjustment and compromise. And if this is an idea of marriage, as Sadhguru, my guru always says, the idea of marriage is to multiply joy and not to multiply misery. Sadhguru always says, you being an husband or wife are companion to each other. You are co-travelers. And your idea is not to multiply misery. Your idea is to multiply joy. So there will be adjustment and compromise. Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. There's a question from a student. Sir, please suggest books for studying mind in homeopathy.
So my sir always says that learn Materia Medica the other way around. So you always try to learn Materia Medica from the repertory rubrics. And then after extracting the rubrics of a particular medicine, as I have seen you, I have extracted the entire rubrics of Staphysagrae and divided into psora, psychosis, and syphilis. Then the shades become clear. After the miasmatic cleavage of the entire symptomatology of Staphysagrae, you can then go to the source books. You can go to Allen's Encyclopedia, Materia Medica Pura, and Herring's Guiding Symptoms. And after that, you get a clear idea of the medicines. Then my sir has written beautiful books on Materia Medica, genetic Materia Medica. In it, he has clearly taught how to learn Materia Medica, how to learn Materia Medica symptom by symptom, how to learn the disposition of each and every remedy in Materia Medica. It is a very nice book to start learning Materia Medica, Genetic Materia Medica by Dr. Prakul Vijayakar. In that book, you learn how to learn Materia Medica.
Yes, sir. I think that answered the question of that student. Sir, it was a very nice presentation. We have a lot of compliments rolling down from the participants. I would like to take one from our head of the department, Dr. Srinath Rao, from Materia Medica department, sir. He said, very nice presentation and wonderful compilation. And there was some unrest in the group because I can understand children do wait for some tips. So they were interested to know some cases, but I know that this presentation is not aimed at present cases, but in order to give you detail about the Materia Medica. And in response to that, our alumnus and also our old staff of Fathamulla Homeopathic Medical College, who is presently in Dubai practicing, Dr. Alphonse D'Souza, he has replied here, without understanding the theory, Materia Medica, miasms and knowledge of its application, practicing homeopathy is not easy. Showing only cases and prescription may not help. It only makes one impatient. Staphysiatria well explained. So we all agree with this statement. Thank you, sir, Dr. Alphonse, for your very timely message to the group.
Thank you so much.
Yes, sir. Sir, from my side, as a moderator of this session, it was a fantastic session, sir. You have showed us a three-dimensional approach to Staphysiatria. When we heard about the Materia Medica of Staphysiatria, we heard beautifully compiled rubrics from the repertory, and we also heard miasmatically you are differentiated. So we saw the three shades of Materia Medica, Organon, as well as repertory in Staphysiatria. In fact, your presentation need not be explained because you told by your approach itself how to study Materia Medica. This was a very unique way of understanding Staphysiatria. If Staphy was a city, we were the tourists today. We had a wonderful sightseeing. We went through the places very beautifully. And particularly what attracted me was the sensitivity that you explained about Staphysiatria. I always used to think about, we had one approach that any person who is suppressing too much is always Staphysiatria. But you explained that bloated dignity.
Yes.
He actually, that is a mind-blowing experience for today. I think we will carry forward from here with what understanding we have got. You have dissected Staphysiatria very logically. And if a very detailed study of like this is done throughout Materia Medica, it will be a fantastic thing for us. And I also advise the participants that many a times tips are fantastic. It is just like an acute, gratification it gives us. But you know, on the long run, it is a method that is more important. There is a saying, our Srinath Rao sir used to say, it is better to teach the fishing than to give the fish. So sir, today we have understood how to study Materia Medica through your presentation. It was a fantastic go. And we enjoyed every slide, every word that you have spoken. And it is the second time I am hearing you. Last time when you came, I took one tip, sir. I would like to remind you about that. That is, the case in which you presented, you told one point. That is, the person after having food, he was feeling very tired and used to feel very sleepy.
Yes.
And you reminded us that time that that is a syphilitic symptom.
Yes.
You know, most of the time, we never used to understand that fact. Okay, we all used to feel little sleepy after eating food. But, you know, getting tired, food is supposed to give us energy. Instead of that, it is giving us sleep. So after that, I took that. In many of the cases, I seriously observed that syphilitic nature in the patient. Sometimes it is very difficult to catch the syphilis in the patient, and that is the most important thing. Thank you so much for this time. We also got some more things because there is no session which goes without the tips. Thank you, sir. Thank you so,
thank
much.
You so much.
From my side, I express sincere thanks to you, and I express my sincere thanks to you, sir.
Thank you.
Over to Hafiz.
Yeah. On behalf of the organizing team, Provision 2020, I express my gratitude and respect for our distinguished speaker, Dr. Gopushankar M., for sparing his invaluable time for us and enlightening us with his commendable presentation by throwing new light on the familiar drug picture of Staphysiatria. Thank you, sir. I would also like to thank the moderator of session, Dr. Raja Chandra G. I would like to thank the administrator, Reverend Father Roshan Krascha, Principal Dr. Shivaprasad K. and Vice Principal Dr. E.S.J. Prabhugiran for their valuable support for Provision 2020. I express my gratitude to the webinar organizing team headed by Dr. Dheeraj Fernandez, who have been working hard to make this webinar series a successful one. Finally, I thank all the delegates who have dedicated their time in being a part of this session actively. We have the best of sessions in the upcoming days to come. Stay tuned with us. Dear delegates, tomorrow we have a session by Dr. K. Srinivasan on the pattern Boger synoptic key. Thank you and good night.